performers out there.
Thank you.
Those of you on the other side of the street, you may not be able to hear him, but he was singing Praise the Lord and Pass the Ammunition, an old song from that era that kept everybody going forward and fighting the fight. So thanks a lot, Chuck, for once again joining us here on this very special occasion. Well, coming into view is Rosie the Riveter. Now, for those of you who may not know, during World War II, the women were encouraged to step up and fill the jobs left behind when the men left for war. These women worked on the home front during World War II and became known as Rosie the Riveter. Their time in the workforce helped plant the seeds of the women and civil rights movements. Many of these ladies live right here, and if you look close, those pictures that you see right above them are them when they were a little younger. But ladies, you look just as beautiful today as those pictures are then.
They were founded on the old school ways. The teams of Scorts are service members and their families in the time of need. They serve with honor, courage, and commitment, which are their core values. Thank you, gentlemen and ladies.
Well, coming down the street right behind them is the WFA Fish and Adventure. You can join Alex and Grandpa Michael for the Walnut Festival Kids Fish and Adventure being held at Heather Farm Park. This is for kids ages 15 and under. It'll take place next Saturday, September 22nd, and Sunday the 23rd, starting at 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. Fishing poles, bait, and hooks will be provided. It's at Heather Farm. They stock that lake with thousands, maybe a lot more than that, of fish, and they have a great fishing derby there. It's a great time, and I know for a fact that Grandpa Michael also is a veteran also, and he started this thing a while back, and it's a terrific time for everybody who's involved.
I've been there. I took my oldest son there, and we caught one so big that I had to throw it back. Didn't get any pictures, though, unfortunately.
Okay.
So you're just going to have to take my word for it.
All right, I'll take your word for it.
Dave, this is a good time to remind everybody that the Twilight Parade kicks off the Walnut Festival, which is happening September 20th through the 23rd. It's $10 per person, but if you bring a can of food for the Contra Costa Food Bank, you get a dollar off the admission price. And everybody's got a couple cans of food somewhere back in their pantry that they're not using. Mm-hmm. Go to good use.
There you go.
Seniors and active military and children under five are free. And I'll see you there.
Okay.
And coming up here is the East Bay Hungarian Educational Group. Walnut Creek Hungarian School provides cultural, educational, and language development for children and adults. School also organizes an all-day Hungarian festival and family fun in Civic Park next Saturday, September 22nd.
But we have a little bit of a break while the next entries come down the road here. As I mentioned earlier, the Kids Parade, actually, this is a section of the parade where we have a lot of younger folks in it. The Kids Parade in years past, Brendan, was held in the morning time, and the kids would go over to the park. During that time, when the park held the rides, there was only two rides over there, and it was a Ferris wheel and another one called the Spitfire.
Oh.
And the Spitfire was more like a little airplane that flew around that kind of everybody got onto. But they would spend the whole day over there and then come back for the big parade at night with that we're watching now. But now they got integrated into the big parade. They made the big time.
Well, I think we should bring the Spitfire back. Sounds like a good idea. Right?
Yeah, if you do a search on that online, you'll see it was one of the favorite rides of the era. Now, I don't think you find it anymore.
Yeah.
Now, you had an opportunity. We saw the Pearl Harbor survivors there come by. You had an opportunity to interview some of those folks for Walnut Creek Television a while back, right?
I sure did, yeah.
What was that like?
It was moving would be a word I'd use because the memories of that day are as fresh as when it happened. And, of course, now it's decades and decades on. And they have a message to tell people. And it's really interesting to just sit and let them talk because what they've seen is history. And it's moving to listen to those gentlemen talk and what they sacrificed. And some of the people we saw today were actually wounded on that day, so they didn't know what they were waking up to, but it's a day that changed their lives and the lives of America, and we are honored that they're still with us, and we need to take advantage of that while they're still here.
Mm-hmm. In fact, Chuck Kohler, who you saw here, who was singing a little while ago, his message is never forget. Mm-hmm. And his message, and the other ones have other messages as well to remember about what happened. So absolutely, and that December 7th ceremony is usually held up at Cal State East Bay. And you can go, it's free, and you can also watch from the distance when they light the tower, on the top of Mount Diablo,
yeah.
The searchlight up there. It's a very good, if you haven't got a chance to go there, you have, I know, and you've interviewed the folks who've done it, but if anybody else hasn't had a chance to check it out, they should. Incidentally, you may notice that the judges are over here on this flatbed truck to our left, maybe behind you or to your right, maybe in front of you. Those judges are with a professional judging organization that will judge the bands, the first one coming down right now, the Blue Devils. They'll watch for different things. They're going to watch for the lines. They're going to watch for musical, what they hear in the music. They're going to look for presentation and spirit. They have a very difficult job, and they'll also review that information at the end and then give those awards, which actually have monetary value to them in the end. That'll be given back at the park in just a little while later at the end of the parade.
So is it like a cumulative score, you know, where they look at these three or four things and they kind of add it up the total, or
I don't know what their particular sheets are doing, but I can tell you there is a 200-foot section that they'll judge the bands on. They'll enter that section rolling, and that's when the judging will begin.
Hmm. Well, then we should welcome the Blue Devils Sea Drum and Bugle Corps, the youngest group in the world-renowned Blue Devils Youth Organization, and members range in age from 8 to 14. No experience is necessary to be a member. They perform and compete in California field events and local parades. The drum majors are Isabel Cristobal and Cecilia Murillo and Brianna Madi. The director is Rick Odello.
welcome the mayor, Justin Weddle, and his two daughters, Ava and Sophie. Once again, the band is so loud, you probably didn't hear me, but Mayor Justin Weddle and his two daughters, Ava and Sophie, Mayor Pro Tem Cindy Silva, council members Luella Hackscoot and her husband, Ralph, Kevin Wilk and his wife, Jill, as well as city manager Dan Buckshy, who's driving. They're being escorted by Walnut Creek Police. That's important when the police escort you right through the town. All right, well, next, folks. This is a 1922 Model T Ford driven and restored by Ron Wald of Walnut Creek. Next to Ron is Diane Oliver, a lifelong resident of Walnut Creek. In the back seat sits Ron's cousin Mike Simmons and wife Christine Simmons. Ron and Mike's grandfather was James Simmons, one of the original pioneers of Walnut Creek. James had a blacksmith shop and home on Main Street, where Broadway Plaza Shopping Center sits today. So let's give it up for the 1922 Model T Ford, driven and restored by Ron Wald. One of the other things, Brendan, I didn't mention is that the you'll see the next, as the bands come in, every part of what their performance is coming into view will be judged. The flag twirlers and the flag folks will be judged. The drum major will be judged. You know, when some of the other bands come through and you'll see some of the drum majors twirling batons, or in the case of Concord, a rifle. That is all judged, and that's all part of the spirit, and it's also part of the competition that the judges have a difficult time coming up with those scores to make sure who's going to get those awards.
Everybody's got to be on their A game, is what you're telling me, Dave. Right? You got a lot of moving pieces.
Yeah, that's right. And again, that judging area, the only judging area for this entire parade is right in front of King Walnut. So you guys, whoever is in this immediate area right here, will see exactly what they're going to see to judge.
And I think we're waiting on Alhambra High, who are either waiting for us or the judges, or dramatic effect. But either way, it's working.
Most people don't know that the Walnut Festival Association over the years has raised quite a bit of money as a result of what's happened down here at the festival and a variety of different. They've almost raised $750,000 to help out across all around our area.
Wow. Oh, here they come. And here they come. It's Alhambra High School Marching Band and Flag Team. The band is under the direction of Julian George, who shares a last name with someone I know.
That's right. The director of the band, of this particular band, is my sister, Julianne George.
And they're led by drum major Daria Bivens. They'll be performing National Emblem by E.E. Bagley.
Great big group coming down with the banner is the Old Firehouse School, a preschool where children spend their days busy learning through play.
And it looks like they brought out the whole school. Good attendance from the old firehouse school.
And these kids got quite a bit of energy. Remember, they've been pedaling since the other end of
Main
Street.
That's right. Almost done. And not to be outdone, it's the Seven Hills School. They're a nonprofit pre-K through 8th grade learning community with the mission to develop the intellect, engage the spirit, and foster respect for and responsibility to our world. Pretty good turnout for both Old Firehouse and Seven Hills, Dave. I'm impressed.
Yeah, it looks like most of the children in all the area are here on the parade at the
That's
moment.
Right.
Big moment for these kids.
Yeah, I never got to walk in a parade when I was six.
Well, please now welcome the Grace Cooperative Preschool. Grace Cooperative Preschool, our mission is to help children develop a positive sense of themselves by nurturing their inherent joys and energies through the creation of a supportive and challenging environment. We develop their physical, social, and cognitive abilities. As a cooperative preschool, our parents participate in the program by assisting in the classroom, providing ideas and energy to shape the school. Parents learn with their children through an exchange of ideas and other parents and their professional staff. Grace has an ongoing program of parent education through speakers, conferences, and parent education. And they've been making memories for children and their families since 1971. They're located close to downtown Walnut Creek on Tice Valley Boulevard.
We've got a break in the action here, Dave, and I'm going to take this opportunity to remind everybody one more time that tonight's festivities kicks off the Walnut Festival, which happens on Thursday through Sunday at Heather Farm. And I'll see you there. It's $10 per person, or get $1 off admission with a can of food for the Contra Costa Food Bank. It's a worthy cause. It's a good time. You got 4 good days to get over there.
Mm-hmm. And 2 of those days is that fishing event.
Fishing in.
Yeah, fishing in. That's on Saturday and Sunday. That's a big-time event down there, too. Excellent time to spend some time, as you mentioned, catching the big one.
That's right. Dave, I can hear the roar of the crowd. I think I knew who's coming. It's the Concord High School cheer team. We're in for a treat. We've got 3 performances coming up. Inspired by the parade's theme this year of building dreams and making memories, Concord High has decided to create a day at Disneyland experience right here at the Walnut Festival Twilight Parade for everybody.
We want the nut.
Let's get It's not plugged in.
It's all in the scoreboard.
Play again.
Next, we have your reigning King Walnut Award winners, the Concord High School Minuteman Marching Band and Auxiliary Unit. The band, under the direction of Martin Lahano, the auxiliary coordinator is Andrea Rylam Sorum, the percussion coordinator is Nick Mello. This year's drum major is Keon Creeman. Auxiliary captains are Jennifer Escalante and Melissa Woodlett. For this year's theme of Building Dreams and Making Memories, Concord will be performing their Disney Dreamers Medley, featuring iconic Disney hits from Pinocchio, Coco, Up, Moana, and Cinderella. To all the children out there, Concord High wants you to remember that when you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. No wish is too big, so follow your dreams. So please give a huge round of applause to your Concord High School Minuteman Marching Band.
Thank you.
That happens to me every year. Every year, I'm not ready for it. Every year, I jump out of my skin, Dave. Coming up is the Concord High School float, driven by Concord High student Johnny Miller. It was created by the leadership students of Concord High School. The leadership class is led by Leah Darby. And to finish off the Disney theme, it's the Disney Castle. Surrounded is various students dressed up as your favorite Disney characters.
Well, folks, now please welcome the El Dorado Middle School and Concord Mini Cheer Teams. These cheer teams from El Dorado Middle School and Community Cheer Teams are made up of family, friends, and fans of the Concord High Marching Band and Auxiliary Units. All the girls performing attend schools from the Mount Diablo School District. Our captains this year are Autumn and Emma, and the teams are directed by Rhonda Maddox.
It's level number five.
Oh, yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everybody in the castle, come on, let's ride to the candy store around the corner. Boy, say they want some ice cream, bottle really don't want them. Let's stand where we all fall down. The really party hard to the number of sound. I like mini. And as I continue, the gang is going crazy. So what can I do? I really beg you, my lord. To me, dancing is just like a sport. Anything or not, it's all good. Let me interfere with that in the trumpet. A little bit of me, me in my life.
How's everybody doing tonight? I said, how's everybody doing tonight? That's better. Here comes Encore Gymnastics Dance and Climbing. They've been performing and building the character of kids in the community since 1983. Gymnasts span an age, ability, and personality, and they've got beginners from 4 years old to ex-competitive teens to senior athletes. They've taken the fun, fitness, and energy of Encore parties and classes and rolled it all together in one awesome 28-foot mobile gym, which may not have made the trip down here tonight. Thank you, Encore.
Well, from some of our youngest dancers in that last group, 4 years old, to ex-competitive teens, to senior athletes, that's a wide range. Next, we have the Ace Dance Academy. So please help me in welcoming dancers from Ace Dance Academy, located right here in Walnut Creek on Mount Diablo Boulevard. Ace Dance Academy offers classes for ages 2, wow, that's even younger than the other ones, 2 through 18 in ballet, jazz, tap, contemporary, hip-hop, and musical theater dance. Ace Dance Academy. Looks like Ace Dance Academy is giving out bubbles. Well, that looks exciting.
Here come the Girl Scouts of Walnut Creek. Give them a hand. With over 1,000 local young ladies, the Girl Scouts of Walnut Creek are enthusiastic community members. Girl Scouts founder Juliet Gordon Lowe believed in the power of every girl and organized the first Girl Scout troop in 1912. Do you remember that, Dave?
Vaguely.
Okay. Every year since, her organization has helped girls discover their strengths, passions, and talents. And here in Walnut Creek, Girl Scouts are always busy doing amazing things. Thank you, Girl Scouts, and a couple brownies there, if I'm not mistaken.
And following them is Snippets. It's a party like a rock star. Feel glamorous, walk in the red carpet, or lift your feet up and enjoy some pampering with your friends. Feel comfortable is key in their great haircut experience. Our team is here for you throughout haircuts, sensory issues, and special occasions.
And following on their footsteps, it's the Mayor School. Love nurtures growth and learning at the White Pony Mayor School's preschool through fifth grade. And they did a fantastic job with their float.
Boy, didn't they?
Yeah. I'm guessing that was a school project of sorts.
Well, this section of the parade has had a lot of dancers in it, and we're going to keep it going with the next one. This is the East Bay Dance Company. They are currently the 8-time national champions, and they just took home first place at finals again at Disneyland last week.
And here comes the Contra Costa Chinese Cultural Enrichment Organization. It's a cultural community where students can come and learn Chinese folk dance and perform for community events such as this. Their dancers meet once a week on Sunday mornings. And they have age groups from 3 years old, three age groups, ages ranging in age from 6 to college, and adult dance classes. Well, Dave, it's one of the chillier Walnut Festival Twilight Parades that we've had in a while, but we still have the crowds.
The crowd is here. Nobody's left. In fact, I think it's actually getting a little bigger.
Good energy tonight.
Good energy. Well, coming up next is St. Mary's School. St. Mary's School, located off Mount Diablo Boulevard, is a K through 8th grade Catholic school that offers a robust academic program and a faith-filled community service focused for the 21st century learners. It is their mission to guide and support their students as they become lifelong learners, spiritual leaders, and accomplish their current and future goals. St. Mary's invites you to visit their school and see this hidden gem in Walnut Creek. How about giving a wave to St. Mary's School? Well, don't forget, folks, this is just the start of the Walnut Festival events. You know, next week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, that is actually the Walnut Festival events that occur down at Heather Farm Park. And if you haven't had a chance to go down there, please try to visit. It's an excellent time, great rides, more food. I don't think anybody could eat all the food that they, even trying all the food they have there. Well, plenty of rides they have down there, and it's a great family adventure. It's only $10. If you bring a can of food, you actually knock a dollar off the price, too, and you have a good cause for the Contra Costa Food Bank. I don't think they have the Spitfire down there any longer, or the Ferris wheel. Those are gone.
Actually, I believe there is a Ferris wheel.
Oh, well, that's exactly right. And now that I recall, you're absolutely right. I didn't remember seeing that last time. Well, at least one of the two rides, the original two rides, is still there.
A couple of the rides you want to make sure you don't eat too much before you get on the rides, if you catch my meaning.
That's a good advice, good advice.
Well, we've had some stiff competition here, and it looks like we're going to get another one. It's the Northgate High School JV Spirit Dance Team, and they are kicking off what is a long list of Northgate High School competitors here. Raising school spirit through leadership and teamwork, we are welcoming the 2018-2019 Bronco Spirit Team. This talented group of leading cheerleaders and song leaders is bursting with school spirit. The number one goal of the Northgate High School Spirit Program is supporting the Bronco community, which includes athletics, the student body, school administration, and the local Northgate community. Go Broncos!
Blow it in your face. I can't wait to rip you up faster. Yeah! varsity.
Just heard from the Northgate High School JV Spirit and Dance, then the JV Spirit Cheer, then the Varsity Dance, Varsity Cheer, and here comes the Northgate High School Bronco Marching Band.
Coming up is the Concord Kung Fu Academy. Train harder, live better is the motto of the Concord Kung Fu Academy. They've been offering traditional martial arts training in the East Bay for 19 years. Students train in Kung Fu, Tai Chi, self-defense, Chinese kickboxing, and lion and dragon dancing. Children as young as 4 years old up to senior citizens can benefit from training at the academy.
Come on.
Thank you, Concord Kung Fu Academy. Always a highlight of the parade, the Dancing Dragons. Coming up is Las Lomas Cheer. Las Lomas Cheer just passed the torch to Olivia Mahak from her mother, Laurel Landahl, who ran the program for 10 years plus. They've got one JV team and one varsity team, totaling 24 cheerleaders in total, and two coaches. Go Knights!
Thanks again, Las Lomas Cheer. Well, coming up next is the Assistant League of Diablo Valley. Welcome, the Assistant League of Diablo Valley. You can wave and give high fives to the kids on the block, an educational puppet program, one of nine Assistant League's philanthropic programs. In 1967, they were chartered by the National Organization as a nonprofit member volunteer organization to transform lives and strengthen our communities. Today, the league is headquartered right here in Walnut Creek, and they celebrate 50 years in Contra Costa County with close to 450 members and nine philanthropic programs. These programs are funded by the Assistant League's Wayside Inn Thrift Store in Lafayette. So congratulations to 50 years of yesterday and today for the Assistant League of Diablo Valley.
And coming up the street is the Walnut Creek Chamber of Commerce. Riding in the car is Tim Argenti, the board chair for the Walnut Creek Chamber and Visitors Bureau. Hey, Tim. The Chamber helps ensure a strong and vibrant Walnut Creek economy made up of over 700 businesses. They're proud sponsors of the Walnut Creek Art and Wine Festival, East Bay Women's Conference, Leadership Contra Costa, and co-sponsor of Walnut Creek Oktoberfest and Walnut Creek on Ice.
Well, Brenda, we're just past the midway point in the parade, and coming into view is the Walnut Creek Aquanauts. The Walnut Creek Aquanauts is a world-renowned synchronized swimming club based right here in Walnut Creek. Our mission is to develop athletes from novice to elite, building both bodies and minds and instilling skills that will serve our swimmers throughout their lifetime. The Aquanauts, folks.
I'm impressed. Look at these two. That's a long walk. Well, Dave, don't forget, coming up on the 20th, this Thursday through Sunday, it's the 2018 Walnut Festival over at Heather Farm. Costs $10 to get in, or $9 if you bring a can of food, and that goes to the Contra Costa Food Bank. You can buy discount ride tickets in advance, too, at the Walnut Festival office. That's at 500 North San Carlos Drive, Heather Farm Park. What do we got here? What's going on? What's going on? Tell us about this, Steve.
This is Mermaid and Mom. It's a small mother-daughter-run business that provides mermaid entertainment and mermaid costumes, art, and accessories. Mermaid and Mom strives to create lasting and cherished mermaid party memories for children during a fun, entertaining, and safe experience. Wow. They provide children with opportunity to make their mermaid fantasies a reality, and Mermaid Rachel entertains with Merman Lori and assists. They also design and create children and adults fabric, walking, and swimmable mermaid tails, as well as tops, headpieces, accessories, and art. And that's Mermaid and Mom.
I believe this is the first year for Mermaid and Mom at the Walnut Twilight Parade. I didn't remember seeing that. Welcome, Mermaid and Mom.
Well, folks, next we have the Ignacio Valley High School cheer. Ignacio Valley High School junior varsity and varsity cheerleaders. They're excited to be part of the Walnut Festival Twilight Parade again this year. We enjoy these annual events and serving our community. One of our favorite events is our cheer clinic, open to all kindergartners to eighth grade students. This year it will be held in the first week of October, and you get to perform with us on the football field during halftime. They want you to come and join them. The team has been together since the end of July and have been working hard, and they hope that you will enjoy the performance this evening. So under the direction of Coach Karma Christensen and Lindsay Vargas, we present the YVHS cheerleaders. Go Warriors! Give it up, folks, for the Ignacio Valley High School cheer.
And coming up the street, it's Ignacio Valley High School Golden Warrior Marching Band. They are recognized as one of the premier parade marching units in Northern California. Hailing from Concord, the Warriors have marched the world over, performing in parades from Great Britain to British Columbia. The band is led by drum major Hannah Pearson, percussion captain Greg Oka, and color guard captain Paige Nettles, under the direction of Samantha Flansbaum and guard instructor Teresa Minervini. The Golden Warrior Marching Band will perform Eagle Squadron by Kenneth Alford.
I watch you.
Okay.
They're all in. Yeah. The D20 at the gazebo. I just heard this in the house, but everybody, 820 is really good. Yeah, and they're going to do it. We went to go eat at the bar.
And following the band, it's our great privilege to introduce the Brioni's BSA Scout District. PAC 210 from Walnut Creek. Brioni's District is part of the Mount Diablo Silverado Council, and they're dedicated to preparing young people to make ethical and moral choices over the lifetimes by instilling in them the values of the Scout Oath and Law, and to obey the Scout Law.
Here. It was founded by
the Clinton Valley Charter High School as they march off stage here. That was the sixth of our seven bands in the parade here, Brendan.
Well, who could be last? I'm not sure I know who's coming up, Dave.
Well, I'll tell you, before we get to that last band, we do want to introduce the Rotary Club of Walnut Creek. The Rotary Club of Walnut Creek is pleased to be part of the 2018 Twilight Parade. Walnut Creek includes three very active Rotary Clubs supporting our community in a multiple variety of ways, and they are the Diablo View Rotary Club, the Rotary Club of Walnut Creek, and Walnut Creek Sunrise Club. So we want to thank them for being part of our 2018 Twilight Parade. There's the very distinctive Rotary logo on the side of the light blue vehicle coming through. Thank you.
Food, guides, and more food. It costs $10 a person, or bring a can of food for the Contra Costa Food Bank and receive a dollar off.
Please now welcome Antioch High School Cheer. The cheer teams from Antioch High School are excited to participate in the very first Walnut Festival Parade. The squad members from Antioch High's freshman, JV, and varsity teams will be making memories together as they perform for you. Go Panthers!
Cheers to Antioch High School Cheerleading! Coming up the street is Bishop's Cuts and Color. They're a locally owned gender natural hair salon offering cuts, color, and straight razor shaves, men, women, and kids. Come have a beer on us. I will. We empower you to be whoever you want to be judgment-free. We take pride in our craft and go out of our way to be decent human beings. Well, sign me up.
Brendan, coming up is one of the crowd favorites. I think every little child here probably would want to get out there right now and probably take one of those, adopt one of those little horses and bring them home. And their parents are probably pointing them out to them to see those cute horses that are out there. So let me tell you about this. This is Angels for Minis. Angels for Minis of Walnut Creek is a nonprofit dedicated to the rescue and rehabilitation of and rehoming of neglected, abused, and abandoned miniature horses, donkeys, and mules. Angels for Minis has rescued 411 minis and placed 401 of them in forever homes. And they call themselves AFM, Angels for Minis. They're fully funded by donations and staffed entirely by volunteers. So you help their dreams come true. And here it is, the pitch, folks. Adopt a horse. So you can adopt one of these horses. Maybe not one of these specific horses, but you can adopt a horse if it's adoptable. And you think about it, folks, except perhaps there may have been a dog that we had. These are the largest animals we have in the parade this evening. And to think you could adopt them. Well, the cleanup crew always gets a hand. A thankless job that just got thanked.
Coming up the street is Carondelet University Dance Team. This is the first time for the dance team in the Twilight Festival Parade, so welcome.
Carondelet Junior Varsity Dance Team.
Yeah.
Well, coming into view now is the Community Concern for Cats. Community Concern for Cats is an all-volunteer, nonprofit cat rescue organization celebrating 32 years of helping cats in our neighborhoods. The group has given life-saving aid to over 50,000 homeless and abandoned cats in Contra Costa County. And they also work to control the feral cat overpopulation with a very active spay-neuter program, over 1,000 last year. They're supported by donations, grants, and sales at their upscale thrift store.
Following that is the Walnut Creek Swim Club, committed to 60 years of excellence to our summer swim team, offering spring clinics and fall programs for youth 4 to 18. Walnut Creek Swim Team is also proud to host the annual Walnut Creek All-City Swim Meet that brings over 1,300 swimmers, 10 swim teams, and their families together at Clark Memorial Swim Center. The swim club is located at 2771 Buena Vista Avenue, Walnut Creek, right next to the Easy Museum.
And right behind them is the Walnut Creek Warrior Lacrosse Club. Walnut Creek Warrior Lacrosse Club was established in 2003. They're celebrating their 16th season of youth lacrosse from ages 4 through 14. Go Warriors!
And of course, what Twilight Parade wouldn't be complete without Mr. Funnelhead and his buddy Frammy. Mr. Funnelhead, captain of clean water in Contra Costa County, and Frammy the used oil filter. Here they are. Oh, how is he even doing that? That cannot be safe. Mr. Funnelhead wants you to recycle used motor oil and filters. He has certified used oil recycling centers all over Contra Costa County to make it free and easy to dispose of your used motor oil and filters. Mr. Funnelhead finally got smart and got a segue.
Well, Mr. Funnelhead may have made his first appearance here years ago, and this is his first appearance, I believe, riding the segue, although we might advise folks that, kids, we do want you to use your hands when you're riding your segues.
Do as Mr. Funnelhead says, not as he does, as the saying goes.
All right, folks, if you love animals, we want to hear you cheer. If you have a rescued pet in your house, let's hear it. So if you want your tax dollars to help the animals in your community, then let's hear you scream, because I'm happy to introduce to you No Kill Contra Costa. This is your local advocacy for animal shelter reform and implementation of life-saving programs and policies to save our county's pets. With your support, No Kill Contra Costa County is educating the public and county officials about progressive sheltering models that have created entire communities where no healthy or treatable animals are killed. So let's hear it for No Kill Contra Costa County. Brendan, is this coming up into view. Is this the, are the Harleys back?
They are. You better stay out of their way. Some Roadhogs taking up Main Street. It's the Walnut Creek Vespa Club.
Oh.
And they believe that the best method of transportation is not a Harley-Davidson, but in fact, it is a scooter. Find us on Facebook and get together to ride on weekends. Some rides are organized, and some are not. They don't care what type of scooter you ride. Just come ride.
It's an energetic group, the Vespa Club from Walnut Creek.
Well, David, just got a lot louder here.
Are you talking about the Vespas?
No.
Who are you talking about?
I'm talking about the Pittsburgh Spirit Squad. Pittsburgh High School Spirit Squad, under the direction of Latasha Jones and coaching staff Granada Tenzo, Lauren Sharon, Kayla Farmer, Shirley Barney, and others. The Pirate Spirit Squad prides itself on the community involvement in the spirit of giving and promoting pirate pride beyond the school.
Doing it.
Hey, come on, we ain't
Ladies and gentlemen, join us as we venture to a whole new world. We're building dreams and making memories happen when you wish upon a star. Under the direction of Jennifer Martinez, Fernando Alonso, Kirill Bruno, Juliana Martinez, with drum major Leo Ramirez, Pittsburgh High School proudly presents the Pirate Marching Show High School Pirates Marching Show Band.
Everybody, for making it an enjoyable Twilight Parade as always.
And remember, this is just the intro to it. There's more to come if you want to go back to Civic Park right now and watch the results come in for all the bands and a lot of the spirit that's going to be going on and who gets the coveted Nut Award.
That's right. And don't forget, the 20th through the 23rd is the Walnut Festival at Heather Farm Park. So thanks everybody for coming on. On behalf of the Walnut Festival Association, I'm Brendan Moran.
And I'm Dave George.
And we'll see you next year.